Well, gang, we've run by the half-mile post without answering some of your command performance mail. So let's swipe a half second to say hello to all APO and FPO numbers. Picking out old 986 for regards to Butch Schuler, Bug Eye, Pete the Tramp, Model McCurdy, Hammer and Nails Gus, Bones Bauer, Baldy, Blueprint, Sleepy Jones, G.I. Robinson, 2x2 Padazdra, and Pessimistic Campbell. Sounds like my agent. And, brother, look at this. 115 names on a letter from Private Emmett North at 928 and Sarge Ed Cernak at 25 says, keep the home fires burning. I'll be home to warm my hands one of these days. You said it, Sarge. But, fellas, on our trip overseas, I figured we ought to have an orchestra to accompany Francis Langford. And you know me, nothing but the best. So I hired one and paid the expenses to LaGuardia Field. And this orchestra played till it dropped. In Bizzardi alone, it dropped $12 in a crap game. Same guys that sit close to Pack and Mama. But here's the orchestra that made the trip. One big guitar and one swell little guy, the song Priceless, and Tony Romano.
Like the president's smile or a Carnegie style, you're priceless. Like a Winchell remark or a puppy's first bark, you're priceless. Da, 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 da. I know the value of love, and so you see, da 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 da, da. I really mean every word when I say you're priceless to me. Like a Fred Allen gag or a good crying jag, you're priceless.
What's the matter?
Just a second, boy. Did I hear right?
What's
did
that?
You say like a Fred Allen gag? Was that the thing?
That's right.
The mustache is sapping your brain or something. Huh? Like a Fred Allen gag? Is that what you said? The next time you go to Europe, you go by drain pipe, old boy. Watch yourself, sad sack. I'm standing here.
Like Dottie Lemoore's clothes or my pal Bob Hope's nose, you're priceless. Like a band when it swings or like Bing when he sings, you're priceless. Da 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 da. You're in a class by yourself, dear. Wonderful you, like I said at the start, and it comes from the heart. Oh, baby, oh, baby, oh, baby, you are priceless to me.
Thank you, Tony Romano. You know, we had some bad moments overseas, moments that leave a mark on a man, like that night on a little side street in Palermo. It was black and foreboding. Smoke hung over the city. And then it happened. I heard a voice. It came from a radio through the window of a blacked-out beer joint. It was weird. Weird, I tell you. A voice to haunt a man, and it said...
Shoot me the flak and call me Jack if it ain't old High Horn.
My father, Bing Crosby.
Hello, Dad. You got your bags pulled up, haven't you?
Why, you're
if it isn't the jolly little chap with the happy tonsils. Bing, it's good to see your old mug again.
Thank you, Bob, and it's a treat to case your old pothook once more.
Bing, no allusions to my horn, please.
I am agreeable if you'll quit talking about my shirts and my horses and one thing or another.
It's a deal.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't leave us much, does it?
No, it doesn't. Oh, pardon me.
Oh, say, you'll have to excuse Bing tonight. He's a little tired. He just flew back from Washington. He's trying to get Congress to pass a bill to ration Frank Sinatra.
You too, huh? Yeah. That's silly, really silly. We love Frankie. In fact, out at our house, he's our pin-up boy.
Pin-up boy, huh?
Yes, my kids pin up his pitcher and throw darts at him.
It's nice to know everybody has a red skeleton in their life, isn't it? You know, Sinatra could replace you. You know that, don't you, Bingo?
Well, you're mad. You're entirely mad. He read my contract. Says in there a picture a year with Bob Hope. Boy lost interest. Man, he flew, that boy.
Well, panning down to your kisser after being gone 3 months, I see why they're saying those things about your picture, Dixie.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Out with it, fatter than me. What are they saying?
Oh, nothing. Just that the picture won't even pay its mailing cost.
Oh, they're saying it won't make money, huh? You heard that?
Well, not exactly, but the exhibitors took one look at Dixie and said, no hope.
I saw Let's Face It.
I'm saving my money.
Of course, on the radio... I'm getting run into more switches with this guy. Of course, on the radio, following Fibber McGee as you do,
yeah,
you get his overflow and everything. Yeah. You're bound to score a little, but in pictures, yeah, without me, may I tell you that in pictures you'd just be a stand-in for Bugs Bunny.
Yeah. Is that so? I'll have you know I can get along by myself. After all, don't all the producers in Hollywood think I'm a big name?
Not the clean-minded ones. But speaking of talent, did you run into any of our stars over there, Bob?
Read your script that says other stars. So... Watch that. As a matter of fact, I ran into Jack Benny in London. We had 8 o'clock tea together.
8 o'clock tea? Don't you mean 4 o'clock?
I'm talking about when he picked up the check.
Oh. Must have been a great trip, though. Look, give me the lowdown, will you, Chisel Chin? And when those bombs were dropping, bullets were flying, bombs dropping. Did you show the white feather?
What's that?
Well, when you're an air raid, for instance, and you break out in goose pimples and your spine turns to jelly and you start to shake all over and...
Is that what they call showing the white feather?
Yes.
Shake hands with an ostrich.
You were right in the thick of it, huh?
Right up in there. Those soldiers really admired me, Harry.
No kidding, Ski Snoot. They admired you, huh?
Yeah, not like some people I know. They even admired my nose.
They admired your nose?
Yeah.
Well, naturally, what soldier wouldn't admire a man who could dig a foxhole with his hands in his hips pocket?
Well, no Look kidding, at those Bob. Ears. He was born with his flaps down. Look at that.
No kidding, Bob. What's it like over there? Knock me the news on the, for instance, on the woman situation. What do they do for dates?
Well, it's pretty rugged, Bing. Pretty rugged. Not a woman in sight. In fact, in the whole trip, the only guy who found a woman was one fellow who stood on a hill in the moonlight for 18 hours and bayed like a wolf.
Really?
Yeah, pardon me while I spray my throat.